sound right, boss? Thanks to a little promise, but it's like
well, thanks. I mean, hey, everyone, this is a Happy Anime Cafe Manager here with another Let's Play for Fire Emblem Three Houses. Alright, so I've expanded my activity points for the day. There's nothing else left to do. Well, except for the support logs. Claude and Flame.
I have told you already. I am quite alright.
You say that, but
I do not care what you have to say. I could not bear to stand here and do nothing.
Flame? Hey there, Flame. Looks like Zenith is as overprotective as ever.
Eavesdropping, were you? Well, you are spot on. I do wish you would leave me be and learn to trust me.
Listen, Flame, before I take a stab at your true identity, I want to ask.
And what is that?
Zenith is your father, isn't he?
Pardon me?
I've been thinking about this for a while, and my latest theory doesn't make sense otherwise. That overprotective attitude of his, it seems like more than just sibling concern. More like a father protecting his only daughter.
How can you be so sure? Hilda's brother and Raphael are quite similar, are they not?
They're both pretty clingy, sure, but even they are willing to let their sisters live their own lives. Whereas, Zenith, there's something more at play there. An entirely different dynamic.
I imagine that is because I...
Even taking into account your special blood and the people targeting you because of it, I feel like Zenith has devoted his whole being to you, like only a father.
My brother with your theory?
As if he'd tell me anything, even if I did. Though maybe if I tried to trick a reaction out of him, I could try calling out Daddy from behind him when he least expects it. Nah, he'd probably kill me if I tried that. Not a good idea.
That sounds most entertaining. I would love to see you give it a try. Perhaps you could request it.
Father, please grant me your daughter's hand in marriage.
Should be done properly when the right time comes.
Do you mean to say that the right time will come eventually then?
Well, you never know what the future holds. But forget that for now. I want to talk about...
As though this were something easily shelved. This topic holds far more appeal than that of identities, if you ask me.
Okay, Claw and Flame are now 8+. Lawrence and Leonie.
It's only a scratch, Leonie. I'm alright.
One mistake like that in battle and you're done. This is your weapon hand, isn't it? Let me stop the blood.
Apologies for the trouble.
No trouble. And no apologies. Thanks is what you say when a friend helps you out. Darn.
What's wrong?
I need a bandage to stop the bleeding, but this is all I've got.
My handkerchief.
I was only carrying it around to give back to you anyway. Mind if I use it for this?
Very well. I suppose that's fitting in a way.
I guess so. Not that I'm happy you're bleeding. I'm glad you'll accept it, though. In the past, you might have refused it.
Yes. I might have made it an issue of commoners giving aid to the nobility or some such.
I didn't understand why you were so strict about it, but I think I kind of get it now. You know, if every noble were like you, the world would be...
you are an exceptional individual. By insisting on matters of status and dealing with you, I have done you a terrible disservice. For that, please accept my apology. Let us promise to look out for one another as friends from now on.
No need for vows. That's how I've always seen it. You weren't wrong about nobles and commoners each having their own roles. But the important thing is we help each other.
That is precisely what being friends with you has helped me to understand. In fact, I've begun somewhat to think of you as rather something more.
Huh? Sorry, what did you say?
I said, I will always give each other support.
Ignatz and Leonie.
Hey, Ignatz. Drawing again?
I am. I suppose that's rather irresponsible, as we're in the midst of a war. But ever since we last spoke, I felt keen to pursue my artistic aspirations.
Like I said, it's your calling. Don't feel bad about it.
All right. I'll try to embrace it. And you, are you practicing archery today?
Or just double-checking this bowstring. I want to make sure it's ready for the next battle.
Okay. Well, let's both do our best.
That's the spirit. Does that mean you finally accepted that you're an artist?
I'll try to discuss it with my parents after the war. There's little demand for knights in peacetime. In fact, painting might be a more reliable way for me to support my family. I'll try to persuade them with arguments along those lines.
Good point. I'm glad you got some confidence.
Come to think of it, Leonie, what will you do when the war is over?
Me? I'm going to become a top-tier mercenary.
A mercenary in peacetime?
Even after the war's over, there'll be plenty of work for me to do before peace really takes hold. I'll pay what I owe my village back, with interest. After that, I don't know. Never thought about it.
I'm sure you can do whatever you put your mind to.
Hardly. Lots of options just don't suit me. I mean, could you imagine me as a songstress? But yeah, I don't know. Once I've paid off my debts, I guess I'll just have to find something new.
I don't think there's any rush. You can travel and relax. Think about it.
Travel, huh? There's an idea. Wanna come with?
Huh? Me?
Sure. You were really excited about different styles across the world, weren't you? Don't you want more of that? Maybe even see the sky in a new shade.
Yes, I suppose I do. I'd like to see the whole world.
If your parents object, we'll just say I kidnapped you. Actually, feel free to say that even if you go alone.
Oh no, I want us to see the world together. Your presence makes every landscape more beautiful.
Hey, hold on. What's this all of a sudden?
Oh, that's not what I meant.
You're hilarious, Ignatz. There's never a dull moment with you around.
Hilda and Sedith.
Oh, it's Sedith. I'd better slip away before he...
Ah, I see you are indulging in a bit of reading. You are fond of books, I take it?
Yes, reading's one of my favorite pastimes. I was just finishing up, actually, so I think I'll...
That is most fortuitous.
Fortuitous? How do you figure?
Come with me. I have a story to share. Once upon a time, deep in the cold mountains, there lived a lazy fox and an industrious squirrel. The squirrel worked tirelessly all day long, while the fox did nothing but lounge around and play. When autumn came, the squirrel hurriedly gathered up acorns for the winter. The fox continued to play without a care. A biting winter fell upon the land. The mountains, caked in snow, concealed all nourishment from sight. The hungry fox went to the squirrel's dwelling, but the squirrel had locked up tight, gone to sleep. Every so often, the squirrel would wake, enjoy a nibble of an acorn, and then return to an easy sleep. The fox
on the other hand, with nowhere else to turn, was forced to scrounge for food in the bitter cold of the forest. Forlorn and hungry, he wandered in solitude all through the winter, until spring came once more. And so it is to this very day that foxes are denied the comforts of hibernation.
Ah, I really learned something about foxes. I read lots of fairy tales like that when I was little. But the lazy fox and the industrious squirrel, huh? That one I don't think I've heard before.
That is not surprising, considering I wrote it.
Oh, you wrote it?
When Flame was young, she loved fairy tales more than anything. I would read them to her often. This one, however, is a more recent creation. I wrote it for the benefit of the children in the monastery. So, what do you think? I'm curious to hear what sort of impression it made on
you. It's so cute!
You found it to be cute.
I can just see it now. You writing fairy tales for your little sister. That's just the cutest thing. Honestly, to me, you usually come across as stern and overly perceptive. But now I know you have a sweet side, too. I feel like I'm seeing you in a whole new light.
That is not what I was hoping to hear.
Yeah, the moral of the story is get your ass to work or you'll be dead, digging through trash cans like a raccoon. But still, if a raccoon, you're a fox. Okay, Leonie and Sedith.
I know the fellow you are referring to. Yes, I've seen the way he looks at you. I recognized in an instant that he had impure feelings for you. As your brother, I took it upon myself to test his resolve. I merely asked him if he was prepared to lay his life on the line for my beloved sister.
He is nothing more than a friend! Kindly keep out of my social business in the future!
I am happy to see that you are making friends. You should weigh your options more carefully.
Who I befriend is absolutely none of your business! Do you know what they call people like you? Overprotective meddlers! I am no longer a child! Are you incapable of trusting me, even a little?
Of course I trust you, but as an elder brother, I have a certain responsibility.
As my brother?
Obviously.
Oh, never mind it. If you'll excuse me.
Have I already Ezra Ranglioni? A lot of time has passed. Anyway, time to call it quits here. I don't think there's anything else I need. Professor Expertise, Strength plus 2. Now at Lance Prowess 4. Okay, I could go back to teaching him faith.
I'm getting it. Let's see it.
doesn't seem like she has a whole lot going on for her. Yeah, no skills on anything else. But you still gotta work on her for a reason. Should I direct him to? Get a perfect, have a focus, only get what. Oh, shoot. Thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time, to be continued, baby.